And the Bible says that he sat at the table. In another translation that I studied, that I preached this morning, says the Pharisee begged him to go. And he sat at the table. His feet are dusty. He's got his sandals. And he's just waiting. No ministration to him. Just waiting there. And then he's thinking. Jesus is thinking. Well, he hasn't washed my feet. He hasn't given me a kiss. Because it was a custom. The Bible mentions it as holy kiss. I'm tired. I've been preaching all day. He has not anointed my head with oil. This is what the Lord is thinking. Like, I wonder, what am I doing here? Why was I invited? And I'm not ministered to. And I said to you this morning, Jesus loves to be ministered by you. See, our way that we see things is that gimme, 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 gimme. Remember what Kennedy said, our president, ex-president Kennedy? Ask not what your country can do for you. I'll say it like he said, ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country. And I said to you, ask not what Jesus can do. What Jesus can do for you, ask what you can do for Jesus.
Amen.
You know, it struck my heart because I saw in the spirit my master, whom I love, and love of my life. And I saw him in that period of his ministry neglected. I'm talking to some of you this morning. Why you invite Jesus to your house if you're not going to cater to him? Why do we say, come, 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 Jesus, to the house if you don't really care if he comes or he doesn't come?
Come on.
Administer to him. Number one says, and behold, a woman in the city who was a sinner. Turn to someone and tell someone that the woman was a sinner, right? When she knew that Jesus sat at the table of the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster flask of fragrant oil and stood at his feet. Behind him, weeping, and she began to wash his feet with her tears and wipe them with the hair of her head, and she kissed his feet and anointed them with a fragrant oil. Now this woman, like we know, she was a sinner. And that fragrant oil was something that she used for her trade. It was very valuable. The alabaster was valuable. And the oil that was inside was very valuable. But notice this. This is what strikes me. Here is Jesus. He says, come and wash my feet. Talking about the master. No one has given me a kiss. No one has anointed my oil. Of course, the food wasn't going to come until these three the back of her, a lady comes, a woman, and she was and she was not invited by Solomon. And I know, because Solomon was a Pharisee. And a woman should not be seen in the house of a Pharisee. This is why the woman comes through the back door and sits in the back of Jesus and pours out the fragrance and cries and wipes his feet with her hair. A Pharisee was a very religious person. They knew the Torah. They said of the Sanhedrin. They knew the law. They knew everything. But yet when Jesus comes to the house, Jesus is neglected. And I know that God is speaking to some of you, that you are very religious, but you neglect Jesus in your heart. You don't love him the way he loves to be loved. Jesus loves to be loved. Jesus loves to be worshipped. God abides in the midst of praises.
Yeah.
When there's praise, Jesus is there. And if you get bored praising here, heaven is going to be boring for you. But he abides in the praises of his people. God takes notice of the service that is offered to him. The problem of judging others, point two coming. Now when the Pharisee who had invited him saw this, he spoke to himself. We are very quick to pass judgment. Come on. We pass judgment. We look at the outside. And some will say, well, why did they invite those shows? You know, we should be dressed like this. We pass judgment.
Right.
Oh, that guy is an alcoholic. Sit him in the back. Come on. Pass judgment. We think we're goody-goodies. Well, God wants to say goody-goodies too. And he spoke to himself, this man, if he were a prophet, no wonder he is seated there and rejected because he didn't even believe that he was a prophet. Lest be the Messiah. No wonder he is rejected because he didn't even believe he was a prophet. And this is why many of you reject, because you don't believe. Now don't get mad on me, okay? I love you.